essentially what the Cure All is providing for you is some security certified authentication and some security storage for your web certificates, for your keys, etc. And it will work closely with the 1800 or 4800 microcontrollers, so that we have examples of them working together. In fact, we have an evaluation board that has both on them if you're interested. Let me hand it over to Nick from Zentry.
What we were talking about moments ago was trying to avoid a ground-up design. Why avoid a ground-up design? The most important reason to do that is because while you're designing, you're burning money. If it takes you 3 years to get a product out, that's 3 years of burn before you start making money. Now, a competitor may be talking to customers quicker than you. So it's very important to try and maximize the tools that you've got going. So the tool that we're talking about today primarily is our operating system. It's the Zentry OS, as we call it. Zentry OS is a complete stack specifically designed for embedded devices at the edge of a network primarily. So all of the little things that you might not think about until you start getting into this product are built into Zentry OS. So for example, if you wanted to build a cloud product, you might need multiple connections. Do you need a local connection? Do you need a cloud connection? If you're talking to the thermostat while your wife or your husband wants to kind of get some information out of the thermostat, where are all these connections coming from? So managing those connections is actually quite tough. Making sure that you're servicing all those people in the time that they expect is pretty tough. And the same token, a serial interface. What if you do have that external microcontroller? How long is that microcontroller going to give you across the interface? So all of these things are quite timely choreographed so that we can support the maximum number of connections with security at the same time to ensure your product is secure. But the same token, there's also all these other things that you might want. You know, servers, that's web servers. You want to put nice, pretty web pages together. You want them to run locally. Maybe you want them to run in the cloud. Well, if the cloud's down, if the Comcast internet connection's broken, how do you maintain that product, right? So if your thermostat has to go via the cloud and you have Comcast out, what are you going to do? Well, you're either going to freeze or you're going to need to start taking stuff. Right, so that's very important. And a lot of cloud providers want you to channel through their cloud. So when you do your design, you've always got to think about the flexibility of your product and how these problems affect you along the way, and of course your customers. So of course, there are lots of things that we want to do with an operating system. We want to look at the A to Ds, we want to look at the GPIO. We want to do that as quickly and as simply as possible so we can get back to the task at hand, maintaining those connections, giving the results to people that want them. So all of this, as I mentioned, is very tightly integrated. So really at this point, all you need to think about is your app. So if you've been making doorbells for 20 years, the marketing guy says, we need it wireless. Fantastic, we'll make it wireless. 5 minutes before you finish, he said, and I wanted to send a picture from that camera. Where's all these metrics coming from? You didn't design that way. The OS has everything built into it to make that simpler for you. Okay? So, we speak a little bit here about the user experience being kind of the most important thing. Yeah, from an embedded standpoint, you want it to work, you want it to be robust, you don't want to have the returns and things like that, but of course your brand's on the line here. Your customer experience has to be pleasant. Right? There are many products out there that are fantastic products that fail because they didn't think about the user experience. So what we want to do is, when we turn to this slide, let's just think about these people. We mentioned this a little bit earlier. We quickly glazed over it to say there are multiple people. But those people have different reasons. We've got the shop owner. He wants to know that his revenue machine isn't broken, right? He's not going to have a vending machine if it can't vend, right? So how can he want that? Well, maybe he wants text messages in his pocket. Maybe he wants to know that there's no stock in a given thing. He needs that information to make money. The other side of things, manufacturer. Well, if you've got a vending machine and it's got six layers of products, but nobody ever buys from the bottom three, why are you spending money making the bottom three? Make the machine smaller, right? Offer different features. You can only get that really from a connected product. So a connected product could live stream good information back to the manufacturer, that manufacturer you, right? You are arguing with your component distributor over 10 cents, 5 cents, 50 cents, but you insist on putting a button on the product, let nobody use it. So this information is really good information to help you get a better product. And that's where the connectivity at the manufacturer really starts to help. Of course, there's other guys. There's the stock guys. You want to know what sells best. Is it, you know, generic brand cola or is it, lemonade? I don't know. You've got the maintenance guy. He pulls up in his truck. Does he want to get out of the truck if the machine's okay? He just has the machine from outside. Continues on to the next guy. The end user, of course. Well, this is the most important person so far. But we just introduced four new people with a valid reason to get data out of your product. Now, every product's different. It may not be this many, it may be more, maybe less. But thinking a little bit out of the box in terms of connectivity and what it can give you can make a vast difference to what that product does and the user experience they expect to get. Now, there is, of course, one problem. And that is, what platform does that end guy use? Well, we all know that the guy that wanted to buy from this vending machine put in a bit of money in, he wants a couple of buttons and a couple of flashy lights. But the account manager, he loves his Android, he's going to use nothing but Android, okay? Meanwhile, you've got the inventory manager, you know, he wanted to use his Windows machine. You've got the shop owner. Yeah, the inventory guy's got a machine this big, but the shop owner likes his laptop, right? It's a small screen. Can we get that information to the people appropriately? So that sounds quite complex, actually, and once you start thinking about it. So there are actually really two ways to go about giving that information from the connected aspect. Of course, it's the money into the vending machine is always going to be the money into the vending machine. Well, that's not necessarily true. Credit cards, that's a cloud service. Certain payment mechanisms, you know, that's a cloud service. But let's talk about physical device sizing. So you've got guys that like the browser. So what's really good about the browser? Well, fundamentally, what's really good about the browser is it doesn't really change very fast. Right? There may be lots of browser vendors, but fundamentally, the experience remains the same for a couple of years and ago. there are similarities whether you're on PC or Mac. The new browsers are all supporting rotating phones, and so it gives you that similar experience across devices. The con of this, of course, is that if you're making a local connection versus a cloud connection, you now need to have web files in your product. You know, the HTML, the colors, the graphics, the this, the that, the other, to provide that experience to the end user. So it does use a little bit more bandwidth, of course. It will require you to have more memory to store those files. Good news is, Venturi OS has a file system in it. But fundamentally, you're sending both the graphics and the data, right? Now, the apps guys, they will tell you, you've got a rich environment. Now, everybody's phone is fantastic. Can you imagine going back 20 years and just remembering what you had available to you then? The phone, the tablet, it's a fantastic experience, but here's a problem. Yesteryear, I was on this given phone. Now I'm changing to that phone. The screen size changed. The operating system's changed. I've got to rewrite my app. So the downside of an app-based strategy is you're always in a maintenance loop, right? That's not necessarily a bad thing, but where do you draw the line to get onto the next product? And you've got a whole pile of information being fed to you as a manufacturer that says, they like this, they like this, they don't like this, they like this, they like this, they like this. You've got to now stop dealing with that because the phone vendors have just brought out the new one, right? That's a yearly thing, right? So we think about that a little bit in this respect. Now, again, as a company, essentially, we try to address a lot of this. So we do have a mobile SDK, which has a lot of libraries, which take care of a lot of stuff for you. But that's one of the important things to think about generally. Okay, so quick summary. I said Venturi OS has got a lot of this stuff in. So in the top corner, here's an example of a web page being dished up by this microcontroller across this radio that I've got in front of me. And I'll show you this if we have enough time at the end. So there's an embedded web server built into the OS. There is a read-write file management system, a secure management system. We support MVNet. So what is MVNet? Well, do you want to get your product out and go 192.168.1? What's the number? Or do you want to go myvendingmachine.com? Right? That was easy. So MDNS gives you that functionality, and it's a user experience functionality. The benefit is, if you're going through your home router or going up to Comcast and coming down, if that connection breaks, MDNS will work. Right? So there's other things to think about. You know, you're here thinking cloud. So yes, it supports REST. Yes, it supports WebSocket. It has a number of APIs supporting from it. So if you like to use JavaScript, if you like to use Python, all these things are, you know, managed by the Venturi system as well. Of course, as I mentioned, we have the mobile SDK, which gives you the ability to do app cricket. So here in the bottom right-hand corner, there's a quick screenshot of a reference app that we have. But moving on, let's talk about the topic that fundamentally you thought we were going to talk about. This is still a massive topic, okay? So, we've got to think about a couple of things. First off, let's get the terminology right. When we talk about a cloud, it's not the internet, right? What a cloud is, or what the cloud is, it's these are services that run somewhere, right? So, if you've got a company that runs a cloud, great, that's a the cloud. But if you suddenly want to use analytics,